folks. We're doing another one of our application videos, and this one is Utah. Utah is one of the more complicated states, and for 2023, there is no state that has as many changes going on as Utah does. So you're going to want to pay attention to this video from start to finish. Like all of our videos, this one's brought to you by Go Hunt Insider. If you want the best draw odds, strategy articles, all kinds of stuff, desktop maps, mobile maps, great gear shop, go to Go Hunt, sign up for Insider, use promo code Randy, and they'll give you $50 of credit in the gear shop. You know, we always start with the deadline. And this year, we have a huge change in the deadline for Utah. Utah was always early March. They have moved their deadline out to April 27th. And the reason they did that is they got a lot of complaints that that early March deadline, nobody knew what the quotas were gonna be because the quotas hadn't been approved. Well, they get approved sometime in, I think early April. So now with that deadline of April 27th, we're gonna know what the quotas are that have been approved by the time the deadline comes around. So even if you wanna get in there and apply, they're gonna let you modify your application up until April 27th. But don't miss the deadline. I say that all the time. I feel like I'm the parent talking to the kids about don't miss your deadline. Eat your broccoli, brush your teeth before you go to bed. Now, what are the big changes for this year? I'm gonna give them to you in a general sense because there's so many of them that if I went into the gory details of all of it, we'd be here forever. But the big changes are coming in terms of elk. So they redid their elk plan this winter. It's implemented and in effect for the 2023 draw. And they're reshuffling the deck in a big way. They'd always put a lot of emphasis on the early rifle tags of September. Well, when you have that many tags in a hunt that has super high vulnerability, right, success rates are off the charts, you can't have a whole lot of opportunity. So they're gonna reduce the number of early rifle elk tags in September, and they're gonna cut that season down to a 5-day season. Now, the rest of those rifle tags are gonna get moved over to a bunch of new seasons in October that are called mid-season hunts. And a lot of them are gonna get moved over to late season hunts that are in November. Now in the archery, if you wanna call it tier of elk tags, they're gonna extend the early archery season by a few days. So it's gonna go deeper into the rut. So that's gonna make archery hunts in Utah a lot more attractive because they always started archery early and they ended early, so you missed a lot of the rut with Utah archery elk. Another thing they're adding, they're kind of following in Arizona's footsteps here. In December, they're gonna add a bunch of hunts that have archery elk, right? No bugling, no rutting, gonna be purely spot and stock. But they're gonna add a bunch of those in most of their elk units. So that's a lot of change. I would suggest you go out to the regulation booklet and look at all of this. Out on the strategy article that Go Hunt is doing for Utah, it's gonna explain all this. It's gonna explain it in way more detail. But since most of us are interested in Utah elk, that's one we should be paying attention to, is how this whole thing is changing in 2023. Now, this is one of the states where I want to focus on the draw odds and what's going on with point buying. Okay, in Utah, you have a whole group of non-residents who apply, and then you have a whole bunch of them who just buy a point. These people buying a point don't even show up in the draw odds. And the illustration I'm going to use is for elk. And the reason I'm going to use elk is that's what most people are interested in. It's the hardest species to draw of the deer, elk, and pronghorn. And there's a ton of people buying points that you don't even see. And how big is that number? Well, I went to the 2020 stats, and you're gonna fall over when you see this. 19,947 non-residents applied for the 283 non-resident elk tags. That's one tag for every 70 applicants who actually applied. But here's the kicker. We had 17,674 non-residents who just bought a point. And if you look at the people who just bought a point, these are really high point holders. A lot of them have more than 15 points. And they've just been sitting over there. So those of us who think, all right, we're getting close, this might be our year to draw, all of a sudden some of these point buyers, whoom, they jump in and create what we call point creep. And before you jump into Utah, I want to give you just the dirty of it. If no other non-resident ever gets into the Utah system, they have 133 years worth of non-resident elk applicants in their system right now. I don't want to discourage you. If you got the budget, you know, go ahead and do it. But that's why Utah always, when I'm doing these videos about budgets and allocations of your time and your money, that's why Utah ends up really low on the scale. Because when they have 133 years worth of applicants in their elk pool, non-resident applicants, that's, you know, maybe you save your money and you just go buy raffle tickets from one of these nonprofit groups that have a governor's tag or something. But if you're like me and you have a lot of points for some other species, or you buy a license because maybe you go hunt general deer or something, well, what the heck? You may as well buy a $15 raffle ticket and throw your name in the hat, not just for elk, but for everything. So if you have the money and you don't mind probably losing that money, go ahead, do Utah. So Utah, for non-residents, has a system that it's pretty close to the system for residents, but we get a few more options than the residents. They let us apply for every species. Residents, there's some restrictions in what you can apply for each year. So what I'm going to tell you is the opportunities available to non-residents. All right? We have one part of the system that we'll get into that is for general deer. That has its own system. And then all of the other species, I'm looking at them here. Limited entry elk, deer, antelope, moose, bison, mountain goat, desert bighorn, Rocky Mountain bighorn. They're all under a different system. So, for all of us who are non-residents, we can apply for every one of those that I just rattled off. And here's what it's going to cost you to do this in Utah. You're going to have to buy a non-refundable, non-resident hunting license that is $72. And then, every one of those species you apply for, you're going to pay a $15 application fee. Now, if you draw, all the other charges are going to be put on your credit card. So you're kind of hoping that you see a hit on your credit card from the Utah Division of Wildlife. Now, here are the fees for non-residents. General buck deer, $593. Limited entry deer, $768. Elk, $1,000. Antelope, $337. Moose, bison, mountain goat, desert bighorn, Rocky Mountain bighorn, all of them are $2,200. Utah's fees prior to the big fee increase in 2021 were a lot lower. 2021, they cranked them way up. Now they're up to these numbers that I just gave you. Now let's get into how the Utah system works, right? They have a point system, and actually they have two point systems. The easy one is general deer. That's on a preference point system, right? We all know that preference points, those systems, the person with the most points gets the tag. All the other species are on what's called a hybrid bonus point system. And as non-residents, we are capped to 10% of the tags in any hunt code. But the good news is in Utah, they actually allocate a pool of non-resident tags. Whereas in states like Montana, Idaho, Arizona, they say up to 10%. So residents and non-residents are competing for the same 10%. So we may not even get our 10% in those states I listed. In Utah, they put aside a category that is strictly the 10% pool that all of us non-residents are fighting over those tags. Now I want to get into more detail of this hybrid bonus point system and how it works. Hopefully you got some time here, because this is why I say Utah is one of the more complicated parts. They take this hybrid draw for every species and they split it into two parts. So the first part of this draw functions like a true preference point system. So half the tags go into the first part of this draw, and we're all put into this first part of the draw. And whoever has the most points, that's who gets those tags allocated in the first part of the draw. So now everybody who doesn't draw in the first part, which is most of us, gets moved over here to the second part. And in that second part, the other half of the non-resident pool is allocated under a true bonus point system. So bonus point systems we know are like raffle tickets, right? If you have 10 raffle tickets and I only have one, you got a 10 times higher probability that your number's gonna get picked than I do. But I still could win the raffle with only one ticket. So that's how the second part of the draw works. Now, here's some other complications we need to know with Utah. As a non-resident, we are only allowed one limited entry tag a year. So they go through the draw in a certain sequence. And if you draw early in this sequence, all the rest of your applications are tossed out and you get a bonus point for those species. So here's the order in which they do the draw. Limited entry deer, limited entry elk, pronghorn, the sheep, moose, mountain goat, and bison. So if you drew a limited entry deer tag, which is the first species that they do in the sequence of this draw, all the rest of your applications for any other species are thrown out and you're just awarded a bonus point. And then after that, they do the general deer. So you can draw any of these limited entry ones, plus you can draw general deer. Have I lost you yet? If not, you're doing a good job of following along. A couple other short things. To hunt in Utah, you gotta be 12. To even apply, you gotta turn 12 by the end of 2023. But you have to actually be 12 when you're out hunting. Hunter education is required for anyone who's born after December 31, 1965. You can return a tag in Utah. I don't know why you would, but you can. The odds of drawing again is really, really hard, so find a way to go hunting. Remember, we got a deadline in Utah. It is April 27th, 2023. Download their regulations. Make sure you look at all the changes for this year. There's pages of it. And if you're a member of Go Hunt, go and read the strategy article. Brady and Trail and Brandon and those guys do an amazing job. They get into way more detail than this video has. And if you want to sign up for Insider, go to gohunt.com. Use promo code Randy when you sign up. They'll give you $50 of credit in their gear shop. And if you do apply in Utah, good luck.